apply the Laplace transform of this initial value problem of this equation. So you can see we have the function f of t in this the integral. So you could evaluate this one. But what about this one? Well, the easier way to do it is to convert it into another world using the convolution. So if you still remember this, this is a different way of writing. So again, you have the integral of the function times of u and the function times of t minus u. So this can be written as f of t convoluted with cosine t. Okay, and the u right here, so just u times this. Right, now what I'm gonna do is to apply the Laplace transform on both sides. So on the left side, I have f of s, capital F of s, plus the Laplace transform of this one is u times capital F of s times s over s squared plus 1 equals 4 over s plus 1 plus 1 over s squared plus 1. Okay, now you can see we have capital S of s, this one, so I'm going to factor this out. Then I have 1 plus 2s over s squared plus 1. And on the right side, just rewrite it. Right, the next step is where I'm going to multiply by s squared plus 1 on both sides to get rid of the denominator here, the fraction here. So I have capital F of s squared plus 1 plus 2s equals 4 times s squared plus 1 over s plus 1 plus 1. Okay, so now for this one, if you know this, this is a binomial. So if you just rearrange it, you have s squared plus 2s plus 1, and this can be written as s plus 1 squared. So I'm going to divide both sides by s plus 1 squared. So I have 4 times s squared plus 1 over s plus 1 cubed plus 1 over s plus 1 squared, right? So you have s plus 1 times s plus 1 squared, which gives you s plus 1 cubed. Now for this one, I'm going to distribute the 4 and split this out into two fractions. So I have 4 s squared over s plus 1 cubed plus 4 over s plus 1 cubed plus 1 over s plus 1 squared. Okay? So for this one we can find the Laplace transform easily. But for this one, we cannot find the Laplace transform directly. So what I'm going to do is to use partial fraction to break it down into smaller fractions. So do it down here. Let me do it down here. So I have just rewrite for s over s plus 1 cubed. And this can be obtained from the summation of a over s plus 1 plus b over s plus 1 squared plus c over s plus 1 cubed. The LCD is s plus 1 cubed. So multiply both sides by that LCD. I have 4 s squared equals a times s plus 1 squared plus b times s plus 1 plus c. Okay, so if I let s approach negative 1 on the left side, I have 4 on the right side. It eliminates this and this, so I left with c. Okay, now let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s squared. On the left side, I have 4. On the right side, I have a. So a equals 4. Now let's take a look at the leading coefficient of s to the first. On the left side, I have 0. On the right side, so this is a 2s, so I have 2a. So just expand this out and you will see why I have 2a plus b. So I know a, which is 2. So we can find b, and that is negative 8. So a, b, c, we know I, b, c. So just plug it back in here. Okay? So I have a, which is 4 over s plus 1, b is negative a over s plus 1 squared, and c is 4 over s plus 1 cubed. Okay, now this is this. Okay, so let's say you have s 4 over s plus 1 cubed, so 4 plus 4 equals 8. So let me do one more step. Combine this together. Combine this and this. Gives me 8 over s plus 1 cubed. So you have s plus 1 squared. So combine this and this. Gives me negative 7 over s plus 1 squared. And just rewrite this. So 4 over s plus 1. Okay. Alright, we're almost done. So for this one, we can take the Laplace transform, the inverse transform. Now let me use a different color here. So this is our f of s. Now find the inverse transform of this one. So I'm gonna do it aside here. So apply the inverse on both sides. I have small f of t equals, for this one you have cubed. So just ignore the plus 1. So inverse of this is 8 over 2, which is 4, right? 4, and that gives you t squared. But because you have the shift here, so that should be t minus 1. Okay? So you have 2. This one is this, and 8 over 2 is 4. Same for this one, but now we have a squared. For this one, you're gonna have 1 on top, right? And that this one. So you have negative 7 of t minus 1. Okay? Now for this one. Oh, you should just. My bad, my bad. That should be t squared e to the negative 1. My bad. So the shift is e to the negative t. And over here, so we have 7 t e to the negative t. Okay? So t minus 1, I thought about the unit step function, my bad. And the last one we have 4 times e to the negative t. Okay? So that should be your final solution. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.